This is all Barzal. Scores! Mat Barzal makes it happen.
Tremendous individual play by Barzal.
And he puts the puck with precision in the back of the net.
Here with Mat Barzal, the New York Islanders. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
We're going to take you way back, all the way to the beginning of when you started to play hockey. How old were you? How did you fall in love with it? How did you start?
Me playing mini six down in my basement with my dad, like using the couch as nets.
Yeah.
And like, I had the small net. He had the couch. That was his goal. And he'd be down there with me for probably 2-3 hours at a time. Just like I was just going crazy and just so excited to have the hockey stick in my hands.
Here's Barzal. Barzal, save, rebound, score! He got his own rebound! Matthew Barzal putting on an amazing show here.
Did you know right away that you loved it? Were you drawn to hockey specifically over other sports? Did you play other sports growing up?
I played lacrosse. Played a lot of golf growing up, but mostly just hockey. Maybe every kid nowadays is just playing hockey all year long, and spring hockey kind of got big when I started playing, so it was kind of year round, and I always was excited to go to the rink. So
you never had any trouble keeping it fresh, going to play that much, so it was never an issue?
It didn't seem to be. I mean, come home from the rink and want to go on the concrete in the back and shoot pucks, so I don't think there was an issue with playing too much.
Would you do that? Would you practice at home or play at home? It's not even practice at that point. You're just playing outside, playing in your backyard, playing in your driveway.
Yeah, we had a cul-de-sac on our street, and
perfect.
We would bring the nets down there. I can remember we billeted a couple of Coquitlam Express players when I was young, and they'd come out with me, and I was that annoying little billet kid that wanted to play mini sticks at them, all the time. So. I think I was out lots playing.
He's the best skater in the league, and it's not close.
Matthew Barzal, the hottest of the New York Islanders, with his great speed, has tied it.
You're known to be an exceptional skater, one of the very best in the NHL. How did that happen? How did you become such a good skater?
I mean, I'd say honestly just being on the ice all the time. I was on the ice so much, and
were you coached on the ice, or just like go out there and move? Like, were you like getting skating instructions?
Yeah.
Just saying go skate?
I didn't. No, you know what's funny? I didn't really have skating instructions until I was probably 21 before my rookie year, really. So just kind of was on the ice all the time as a kid. And honestly, a lot of visual stuff too. Like, I like to watch the way guys move on the ice, and McDavid and Kane and those guys, just the way they skate and stuff. So I feel like more I watch that stuff, and I watch it real close, and I'd go out there and try to implement a few things.
Barzal trying to create, which he does so well. Brings it in front, he backed it in! Mat Barzal's got his second of the period!
That's just a great play, that's one you expect from a veteran player.
When did you find you were a visual learner? Because everyone learns differently. Some kids want to read, some people want to see it on a board, some people want to watch a video. When did you figure out that watching something that works for you?
I'm definitely not a
chalkboard kind of guy.
Not a read guy. But probably just in school too. Like, I just thought that stuff was easier, and when I'm watching hockey and on YouTube or whatever, just watching videos or highlights or not, watching just the way they moved, like watching stuff in detail, and watching the way Kane stick handles or where he's got his his hands are placed, or how McDavid's turning, like what that's just little stuff like that, I think. And it's not gonna, you can't watch a video and expect to be skate like Connor McDavid the next day, right? But just work on it a little bit and pick up little things.
Barzal finds some time and some space, and he just goes to the open area. What a backhand shot that was. Boy, this kid's something, isn't he?
So you're obviously an exceptional talent growing up. At what point did you think, I want to do this, and what point did you think, I might be able to actually do this for a career?
I'd say at the Brick Tournament.
The famous Brick Tournament.
The famous Brick Tournament. So,
that's young, though. That's 10 or 11 years old. How old is that?
Yeah, I think we were... had like 10, 11, 12
minutes.
I remember playing against Mitch Marner, Noah Hanifin, Dylan Strome. I actually traded jerseys with Dylan Strome at the tournament.
At the Brick Tournament?
At the Brick Tournament.
You gotta trade him now.
It's probably somewhere in my garage in the bottom of a box or something. But I'd say the Brick Tournament, just a lot of top end talents, like the top guys from Ontario and Alberta and whatnot, and ended up, our team ended up winning, ended up being the MVP. So I'd say probably there.
That'll do it.
Yeah, I'd say there was probably the first thought I had.
Mat Barzal hammers the line in time, and he scores! Mat Barzal just got on the ice, and he ends it for the Islanders.
in the NHL now. It's a profession. It's serious. Is it still fun? Is it still fun every day for you to go to the rink and to play?
Honestly, absolutely. Like, every day going to the rink is something new, and whether it's I would come in and Eberle's chirping me or Clutterbuck's giving it to me, or, you know, or just a fun banter every day. It's just, that's what I live for. I live being in the dressing room just before practice, you know, just talking about whatever with the guys, and that's fun for me being young too, especially just listening to those guys, you know, tell stories and whatnot. I have a blast every day at the rink, especially being on the ice too, you know, competing with your buddies. Yeah, it's fun.
All right, very well done. Thank you very much, and good luck this year.
Thank you.